Good morning, students. Today we are going to see about 8th standard social science economics unit 1, money, savings and investment. Let's move on to the session. What is economics? The study of production, distribution and consumption of goods and services within a society. It is the study of how people make choice and decision with the limited resources to satisfy wants, needs and desires. Production means producing the product. Distribution means selling the product. Consumption means buying the product. So the economics studied the people how work, earn money, save money, invest, use their time, energy and money. So children, economics means nothing but it is the study of production, distribution and consumption of goods and services in a country. Now let's get into the session. Money is fascinating subject and full of curiosities. Fascinating means very interesting subject. Everyone is know about it. Money is a fundamental discovery which has eased the day-to-day transactions, valuing goods and services and has allowed us to store the wealth and trade in future. Eased means it has made easy. So, money is most interesting subject which everyone are curious to know about it. Next we see evolution of money. The word money is derived from Roman word moneta juno. It is the Roman goddess and republic money of Roman Empire. The Indian rupee is derived from Sanskrit word rupiah which means silver coin. Okay, now let's we move on to the evolution of money. How the money came into the existence? So children, the evolution of money start with the exchange of goods for goods, that is product for product. Now we are progress using for plastic money such as credit card and debit card. Now let's see evolution of money in details. The first stage in evolution of money is barter system. Barter system is exchanging goods for goods without using money in the primitive stage. It is an old method of exchange. The value of bartering items can be negotiated with the other party. Negotiate means the two parties will discuss and finally they will come to the conclusion about the items to the exchange. Next we see the disadvantage and drawback of the barter system. First one is lack of double coincidence of wants. That means person 1 has a sukhat and person 2 has wheat. But we need of human one is rice. It's person 1 wants rice in exchange of sugar but person 2 has sweet. So now what the person 2 has to do is he has to exchange the wheat with somebody who has rice. Again then he have to bring the rice and he exchange with the sugar. So that is the lack of double coincidence of wants. That is complex process. Next we see individual common measure of value. That is no proper measure of value person 1 has milk and person 2 has cloth. And he have to exchange to each other and there is no proper measuring value in this system. So, there is another drawback of barter system. Now, let's see the drawback of lack of indivisibility. So, person 1 has cow and person 2 has chair and both of them has to exchange the product. So we all know that the cow is more valuable than chair. Cannot divided the cow into the past to make it equal value of chair. There is come lack of indivisibility. And fourth one is difficulties of storing wealth. Both of them wants exchange their commodities. So we all know that fruits and vegetables store for long period of times. So this is known as disadvantage of barter system. Next we see stages for evolution of money. Commodity money, metallic money, paper money, near money and recent form of money. First we see about commodity money. In the earliest period of human civilization, any commodity that was generally demanded and chosen by common consent was used as money. Like salt, rice, wheat, weapons, etc. Next we see metallic money. With progress of human civilization, commodity money was changed into metallic money. Metals like gold, silver, copper, etc. Commodity money that replaced on the metallic money. Next we see history of metallic money. According to a father of historian Herodotus, King Midas of Lydia innovated metal coin in the 8th century. The earliest issues of coins in the world are the ancient Indians along with Chinese and Lydians from the Middle East. The first time Indian coins were minted in the 6th century BC by the Mahajanapathas known as Puranas, Harshapanas or Panas. The Mayurias came up with the punch marked coins, minting of silver, gold, copper or lead and Indo-Greek Kushan kings introduced the Greek customs of engraving portraits on the coins. Turk Sultans of Delhi has replaced the royal designs of Indian kings with Islamic calligraphy by the 12th century. The currency was made up of gold, silver and copper. It is known as tanka and lower valued coin known as jitals. So children's higher value coin is known as tanka, lower valued coin is known as jitals. The Mughal Empire from 1526 AD consolidated the monetary system for the entire empire. In this era, evolution of rupee occurred with Shershah Suri, that Suri dynasty defeated human and issued a silver coin of 178 grams known as rupiah and was divided into 40 copper pieces or paisa and during the whole Mughal period. Silver coin remained in use. During the British East India Company 1600, The Mughal currency remained popular, but in 1770 AD, Ferruccio, the Mughal emperor, have permission to the British to coin Mughal money at the Bombay Mint. The British gold coin were termed as Carolina, the silver coins as Angelina, the copper coins as Caperone, and the tin coins as Tinny. Next, we see about paper money. It was found inconvenient as well as dangerous to carry gold and silver coins from place to place. So, invention of paper money marked a very important stage in the development of money. The development of paper money started on the basis of storage of gold, and the receipts were issued by the goldsmiths for this storage. These receipts of goldsmiths were a substitute for money and became paper money. At present, a very large part of money consists mainly of currency notes or paper money issued by the central bank. Next, we see about credit money or bank money. Emergence of credit money took place almost side by side with that of paper money. People keep a part of their cash as deposits with the banks, which they can withdraw at their convenience through checks. The check known as credit money or bank money. Itself not money, but it performs the same as function of money. Next, we see near money. The final stage in the evolution of money has been the usage of bills, treasury bill, bonds, debentures, savings certificate, etc. Recent form of money. First one is plastic money. The latest type of money is plastic money in the form of credit cards and debit cards. They aim for cashless transaction. Next, e-money. Electronic money is money which exists in banking computer systems and is available for transaction through electronic system, online banking or net banking. Online banking, also known as internet banking, is an electronic payment system that enables customers of a bank or other financial institutions to conduct the range of financial transactions through website. E-banking, electronic banking, also known as National Electronic Funds Transfer, that is NEFT, is simply the use of electronic means to transfer funds directly from one account to another rather than by check or cash. Next, we see about value of money. Value of money is mean the purchasing power of money over goods and service in a country. The value of money is of two types: internal value of money and external value of money. Internal value of money means purchasing power of money over domestic goods and services. External value of money means purchasing power of money over foreign goods and services. And next, see about functions of money. Functions of money are classified into primary or main function, secondary or contingent function. Primary functions are medium of exchange and measure of value. Medium of exchange means money is used to buy the goods and services. Measure of value, all the values are expressed in terms of money. It is easier to determine the rate of exchange between various type of goods and services. Next, we see secondary function. The three important of secondary functions are standard of deferred payment, store of value and transfer of value. Standard of deferred payment, money helps the future payments too. Today place himself under an obligation to pay a specified sum of money on some specified future date. Store of value, savings were discouraged under barter system as some commodities are perishable. The introduction of money has helped to save it for future as it not perishable. Transfer of value, money makes the exchange of goods to distant places as well as abroad possible. It was therefore felt necessary to transfer purchasing power from one place to another place. Contingent function, there are basic of credit, increase productivity of capital, measurement and distribution of national income. Next we see savings in banks and investment. Savings are defined as the part of consumer's disposable income which is not used for current consumption, rather kept aside for future use. The banking facilitates saving money through various forms of accounts. Student saving account, saving deposits, current account deposit, fixed deposits. Student saving account, there are savings accounts some banks offer specifically for young people enrolled in high school or college, and they make futures more flexible terms such as lower minimum balance requirements. Saving deposits, saving deposits are opened by customers to save the part of their current income. The customers can withdraw their money from their accounts when they require it. The bank also gives a small account of interest to the money in the saving deposits. Current account deposits. Current accounts are generally opened by business firms, traders and public authorities. The current accounts help in frequent banking transaction as they are repayable on demand. Next, fixed deposits. Fixed deposits accounts are mean for investors who want their principal to be safe and held them fixed yields. The fixed deposits are also called as term deposit, and normally they are fixed for specified period. Next we see investments. The process of investment, something is known as an investment. It could be anything, money, time, efforts or other resources that you exchange to earn returns in future. Investment can be made in different investments like stock, bonds, mutual funds, commodity futures, insurance, deposits accounts or any other securities or assets. Next we see black money. Black money is any money on which it is not paid to the government. Black money is money earned through any illegal activity controlled by country regulations. Black money received in cash from underground economic activity and as such are not taxed. The black money is accumulated by the criminals, smugglers, tax evaders and other anti-social elements of the society. In India, black money is funds earned in the black market on which income and other tax have not been paid. The total amount of black money deposit in foreign banks by Indians is unknown. The root cause for the increasing rate of black money in the country is the lack of strict punishment for offenders. Effect of black money. Double economy, tax evasion, thereby loss of revenue to government, undermining equity, widening gap between the rich and poor, lavish consumption spending, distortion of production pattern, distribution of scarce resource, effects on production. Next we see legislative framework in India against black money. Prevention of Money Laundering Act 2002, Lokpal and Lokayuta Act, Prevention of Corruption Act in 1988, The Undisclosed Foreign Income and Asset Bill in 2020, that means imposition of tax, Binomi Transaction Prohibition Act 1988 amended in 2016, The Real Estate Regulation and Development Act is 2016. So recap the lesson. For the word money is derived from Roman word moneta juno. Border system, men exchanged goods for goods without the use of money. Some of the major stage through which money has evolved are commodity money, metallic money, paper money, credit money, near money and recent form of money. Value of money is mean the purchasing power of money over goods and services in a country. Money is defined by its functions. Anything is money which is used as money. Money is what money does. Savings are defined as the part of consumers' disposable income which is not used for current consumption, rather kept aside for future use. Black money earned through any illegal activity controlled by